Hello and good evening, everyone, and happy Halloween, everybody, and welcome to my Formula One 2020 My Team JPO Career Mode. This is a special episode number 72, and we're at the Spanish Grand Prix at the Circuit de Barcelona, Catalunya. Now, if you missed the previous one, which was the Dutch Grand Prix, be sure to check it out on youtube.com/speedjpinator3 or twitch.tv/speedjpinator3. If there's any old new subscribers out there, be sure to click on that button on both twitch.tv and youtube.com/speedjpinator3. And feel free to I would love to have some new followers and new subscribers out there, so add me in and enjoy my spooky, magnificent show. And we want to wish everybody a happy Halloween tonight. Now, I'm going to be doing a challenge tonight, so I am now dressed happily in my costume. I'm wearing the more like a racing ninja mask costume, and I have my sunglasses on as well. So I'm going to see if I can challenge 66 laps here while I wear my ninja mask over here, but this is like a racing mask that they put on their helmets and everything. So let's see how this is going to compare to get this done. You know, I can see everything, you know, I can see qualifying and then the race, and then I can still see my buttons over here while I have my shades on and everything, but this is going to be quite a bit of a challenge, so hopefully I see the cars shiny and everything else. And we have done a great job in practice, session 1 and 2 and 3, and we continue to have a history in the making, and I wish Polderon, my team, suits and everything else. So enjoy one of my Monster Mash spooky Halloween edition of the Formula One 2020 My Team JPO Career Mode for episode number 72 at the Spanish Grand Prix. So let's see how we're going to qualify here. We're just checking our analysis and everything, and we do expect to have some Halloween rain in the forecast. Look at this. So during nearby 3/4 of the race, we are going to have some rain coming into the area. So it is going to get so if we do see the rain coming in the area, then we'll know it and then we'll see it. So let's see how we can do this challenge, and I hope we don't have any flash wrecks or anything, and we'll race perfectly in there. I know my voice is a little bit slurred to have this thing covered up and everything. So here we go. Let's see how this challenge is going to work here. Let's get ready for qualifying for the spooky Halloween, episode number 72. Here is the Spanish Grand Prix. See, I have my beast with me. I'm going to be watching the whole race tonight. Let me have a little bit of a drink. And I see I'm still driving my black and orange paint scheme for this here at my Formula One 2020 My Team JPO Career Mode. So here we go with the first round of qualifying. Let's see who's the fastest. We've been passed all throughout the practice with a minute 16 times, but I think it's going to be a lot more faster than that. Oh, we're seeing some good goodies. And look at this, and my teammate Tatiana Calderon gets 1:15.272. And Valtteri Bottas is faster with a minute 15.203. Alright, here we go. Let's see how the challenge is going to work.
Okay.
well so far. It would be safe on it. But I can still see everything. They said it's quite a bit challenging, though. Let's see what the time is going to be on the first qualifying lap. It's a minute 15:45:31, and we are P4. A little bit slower, but we'll pick up the pace in the next qualifying. I think we lost them a little bit in some of the turns over there, but that's all right. So we are in P4 with a minute 15:05:31. It looks like Bottas and Verstappen may have changed their engines. But having been 15.272, I had a minute 15.531. We're still running on the old engines, but we'll be able to change it after the Canadian Grand Prix. But if it goes into 60 or 65%, then we'll change it. We expect to maybe change it maybe around the, maybe near the Canadian Grand Prix. Because we already used this first component engine for the last six races so far. Well, let's see if we can be much faster in the next qualifying session. Here we go, another qualifying lap. Let's see if we can try to get a bit more faster. In the first section, let's see if we can keep this up. So we got faster in minute 15.371. Much faster than it was in the previous qualifying. That's when we qualified the fastest in the second qualifying round. You see some of the others that took a medium tire, so and hopefully if we change over to the medium tires, when the rain comes, then we might be able to do that. Oh my goodness, and Max Verstappen, this is the first time he has been the fastest. He is now the fastest at a minute 15. He took another crack a lap at it, and he went to minute 15.236. And that was minute 15.371. But Colbert on losing a little bit of time right now, but she's got to pick it up. Well, let's see what the final qualifying, and this is where it all counts. Yeah, it looks like Max Verstappen smoothed his way going in there. This is going to be a great Spanish Grand Prix race, and even with the Halloween rain to go along with it, hopefully no witches will be wizarding us. Calderon got a minute 14.823. She's about to be on her way to getting her fourth pole of the season. Final qualifying, let's see if we can try to get the fastest time. Oh, so then the 15.218 over D3. See if we can get another lap at it. And Calderon is still the fastest. I am going to take another crack at it. Keep an eye on that fuel. Not easy when you see it with the face on and everything. This could be the fastest lap of the day. Here we go. Let's see if it is. Well, it's a minute 15.23. So it looks like we're going to be off to a P3 position. It looks like we have P3 secure. Let's see if it is. And it looks like Calderon lost the pole. Yes, she did.
It's time to remind ourselves of our top three. Bottas, Calderon, and Hawk. With qualifying wraps up, we now have our grid line up for the big race tomorrow. Be sure to join us then for what will no doubt be a fantastic race.
So Valtteri Bottas now gets his first pole of the season. So Mercedes just outbeat us. So Valtteri Bottas is on the pole for the Spanish Grand Prix. second place and I get P3, and I was even better than Lewis Hamilton. Much better time for Lewis Hamilton. And everybody else is about 9 car lengths faster. I think some of them have taken their second engine component. It looks like Verstappen and Albon have got into the second engine component. Pierre Gasly 9th, and then Sebastian Vettel rounds out the top 10. But it could be an interesting race, so let's see what goes on. Well, what a good job. I got P3, but that's the lowest I've been this season, but that's all right. But we should be able to move up in the field, but we got to be careful with Bottas. He's going to be a tough driver today in the Spanish Grand Prix. So let's see what happens. So Coleman does not get her fourth not enough to secure pole, and then Bottas took another crack at it, but already used up those third tires. Stats is here in the team McLean, but we're still at 23 right now, and Polderon has now moved up to 8 on the team McLean. So she's continuing to make progress on the car and everything, but let's see if we can try to get around Bottas during the race. Edition of the Formula 1 by Team JPO Carrero. Let's see if it ought to be a witchy, spooky race here in the Spanish Grand Prix. Spanish Grand Prix at the Barcelona de Catalunya, and Valtteri Bottas is looking excellent out there in that Mercedes. It looks like they made some upgrades in the car. Let's see if they did. We're going to take a look and see if they made upgrades. No, they didn't make any upgrades. They're still the same, but anything can happen here in the Spanish Grand Prix. Let's take a look at the past and see if I... we're going to take a look at the past here and see where I finished in Spanish. I was 6th, 3rd, second last season, but let's see if I can try to get that elusive win here at the Spanish Grand Prix. I have not won here yet, so let's see what happens here in episode number 62. Big challenge, and we're going to go 66 laps here in the Spanish Grand Prix at the Circuit de Barcelona Catalunya. So let's see if my challenge works and everything with these shades on and then the ninja mask I have on. And it ought to be a great race. Let's see how this is going to go. I hope I don't make any contact with any other cars. So here we go. Episode number 72 is the Spanish Grand Prix. It's already dark outside, so it is officially now. It's Halloween night. Well, it's really 6:57 right now, but it is going to be 5:57 because now our daylight savings time ends tonight, and we set back 1 hour. All right, here's the starting word for this special Halloween Spanish Grand Prix. We're going to take a look at the race director to see if anybody's going to do the medium tire challenge. I'm just trying to make sure my shades don't cloud up or anything. Alright, let's first of all take a look at the race direction and see how it's going to play out. And Montez and Calderon are going to go with the medium tire strategy while we go with the soft tire strategy. The rest of the field, probably from Perez and everybody else, are mostly all taking medium tires. Let's take a look at our race strategy. We'll probably go about maybe 70 laps on these tires, and you know, rain will be a factor in this race. So once we go into the soft tires for maybe 15 laps. For 15 laps, then we'll change over to the mediums, and then when the rain comes through, we should be fine. We should be fine, though, until we go into the medium tires. So they will announce and see when this rain is going to be coming through, because it is going to come through. It starts with partly cloudy skies, then cloudy, and then the rain. This race. The race will last for an hour and 24, but it might be much longer than that. So let's try to brace ourselves and try to get ready. We know that Calderon and Botas are going to be slow on those medium tires, so let's hope we can have a faster pace and then try to stay ahead of them during the race and try to go for our sixth win in a row. So here we go, let's get ready for a spooky formation lap here on Halloween night. And the last time we're going to run our Halloween black and orange car on this very spooky, scary night here at the Spanish Grand Prix. Let's see if we can try to get three in a row, or maybe Calderon can make history today and become the first woman ever to win a Formula One race. Let's see what happens here in the Spanish Grand Prix. Here we go. Let's see how they will do well with their strategy and their medium tires. And now we start to roll away. Check our power unit first. It's down in the 40s right now. Last week we're going to be using that gearbox at 45%. So both guys are down in the lead. It's only the formation lap. On the camera and everything. All right, here we go. Let's hope we don't ram into any cars. I know it's not easy racing this thing with my shades on. I still see everything, but it's a bit of a challenge. Let's see everybody's forming the grid. We're getting ready for the Halloween night. Ooh, five red lights coming on. And away we go with lights out. We're underway here at the Spanish Grand Prix, and I get a magnificent start. I go by Botas. Here comes Calderon, trying to get in the inside of Botas for second. She's got second place. So me and Calderon do a good job. Stay out there as much as we could because we have a threat of rain coming in about the next 10 to 15 minutes. So we may stay out there with these soft tires. But we're going to play a little bit of a strategy. We've done this in Australia. Has now dropped to third place. Hamilton is in fourth, and then fifth is McLaren. And then 20.042. we'll have another 10 to 15 minutes away from the rain to come through. So the witches are going to be magically bringing the rain out and wetting down here at the Cirque de Catalunya. Having a great service so far. I'm wearing my Halloween challenge costume. And I'm about to I had a female driver called on. And I know she's going to be slow because she has those medium tires on. But we may stay out there because we have that rain coming through the area. Yeah, people are going to be surprised when they watch this Halloween episode and how I did this with shades and a ninja mask. It's not really a ninja mask because this is like a helmet cover that they use for racing. And that's another fast time, minute 20.238. Looks like Holderon is doing a very good job with those medium tires. Yeah, that was a nice lap, minute 19.238. Minute 19.958, and we're still fast. If any of you guys are going to my channel, I want to wish everybody a happy Halloween. going to be disabled, and I'm only using it for the street, so that way I don't have to make the same mistake that I did in the Dutch Grand Prix. And I don't know how in the world in Monaco, how am I going to use the overtake. I might be using it on the tunnel and then going off the first straightaway. I'll see if I can use it during the straights too. Still flying out there with a minute 19.858. Well, I'm the only guy that's doing so well on the soft tire. Hamilton is still running the four. How about that? I'm already at the 9.66 laps, so we're in this, and it's getting cloudy, and it's clouding up here at the Circuit of Barcelona. So the few drops that came into the rain, and it is going to be here. So we did a good job in making the right move, trying to go with the soft tires, and pretty much of a bad move for Tatiana Calderon and Botas, and now everybody is going to pit because the rain is coming through, so we expect to see some droplets coming in shortly. I think in the last couple of the laps, I'm going to be using that overtake over to the S, because I won't be able to use it until the end. Minute 19.834. I'm still continuing the search, but it may not be for long because the rain is coming. We're going to go into standard mix now because now we use the whole fuel. That's about still don't see any rain coming into my halo over here. And it's going to come in shortly. out there. And here comes the rain. The rain has now dropped here at the Circuit de Catalunya. So that will be the last time I'm using the disabled overtake going into that turn, because now the rain has arrived here at the Circuit de Catalunya, Barcelona. So now on, we only use the overtake going into the straight. But the rain is here, so let's see how many laps we can stick with these soft tires until we reach over to go into intermediate tires. Alright, so we're not going to be using overtake anymore. Stay out there because there's some of the others that are going into the pits, but they are going to lose track position. We're 13 seconds ahead of Calderon. She's doing a good job out there. We're not pinning on this lap, but we're going to stay out. I think sooner or later the DRS is going to be disabled. We're up to 15 with 66 laps, and it is raining here at the Circuit de Barcelona. And this is going to be a good advantage for Russell and Norris, that they're in the top five right now. I'm so glad they went with this strategy, and I'm doing the same thing too. And it looks like they're going into the intermediate. So on lap 17, we're going to come in to put on the intermediates. looks like everybody else are going to do the same thing too. So we're going to come into the pits to put on medium. What a great job by the strategy. Looks like it's raining pretty badly too. My teammate Tatiana Calderon is coming into the pits too on the same lap. The DRS has been disabled. So now we have the intermediates on, and look at this rain, and it's going to get heavier. Put on the right tire, so that's a good thing. So she's cooperating very well by going into the pit stop and making sure she puts the right tire on. We might have a car out of the race. We see yellow lights coming into that area. We might have our first retirement in the race. Let's see who it is. And it's Lance Stroll. And Stroll is out of the race for the blown motor. What a tough race for the Racing Point team. Tough race for Lance Stroll. Out of the race, the first DNF of the season for the BWT Racing Point. Major Mass doing this Halloween night race here at the Pacific Catalunya. And I'll be doing NASCAR Heat tomorrow, and I'll be in my normal attire tomorrow as we start the major. Back marker cars. It took us 20 miles to go through that. Only a 20-second advantage over Tatiana Calderon. Calderon is about 5 seconds ahead of both sides. Starting to intensify a little bit. Stop and they go into the wet tires. As the witches right now, they rain out of this Barcelona. If anybody going to see the real life Formula One race, they're going to be racing in Imola tomorrow for the San Marino Grand Prix. Good to see them back over in Imola. Well, if we don't have a safety car period, we could bend out a bunch of the whole field. Thank you. so careful with this rain that the rain now gets a little bit heavier. Great run today for George Russell in the BMW EWT Racing Point Mercedes, and Lando Norris is running in the top five in the McLaren. K Mag is gonna let me go by. And he does. Try to put a lap on Peter Benassi. See if he gives me room, and he does. Yep, he does give me room. Yeah, we have it from lap 41 or something. There's no reports yet of dry conditions. Well, we're still staying on the intermediate. I hope the screen is lighting up a little bit. Almost drops down in P18. The Williams cars don't even run very well during the race. And what a struggling performance for Sebastian Vettel. Never seen Sebastian Vettel perform so poorly over here in rainy conditions, and he is in P17 now behind a Haas car with Romain Grosjean. Not a very good Halloween day for Sebastian Vettel. Looks like his magical spell has gotten into a slow performance today. Now we have set it to 44 laps to go on to the intermediate, so we can stay out there as long as we can until the rain dries out. There's no reports of dryness coming in the area yet. Rain is pretty heavy so far. It's 3 to 2015. Already after 30th, 66 laps here at the Spanish Grand Prix, and the rain will be lighting up in the next 10 to 15 minutes. We have about 36 laps remaining here at the Spanish Grand Prix, but they're going to wind down very quickly. It's the first race that will run the shortest Formula 1 circuit in the calendar. F1 doesn't seem to be doing well with the rain tire. They're probably about 4 seconds ahead of the Valtteri Bottas. Russell is in fourth, and Norris is in the top five. Good for wetness on Halloween night. See if we can come up with a thriller finish. Starting to get a little bit slippy out there with these tires. And we're now 30 seconds ahead of my teammate, Tatiana Calderon. Still hanging on into P2, trying to hold off the fast. Three both have. And we have yellow lights that are coming on. Yep, and it's Nick DeFries and the Williams. He is out of the race. And that's the second DNF of the season for Nick DeFries and the Williams car. getting a little bit too high over there. Looks like these intermediate tires are beginning to wear out. The track is going to be starting to dry right now. It looks like we see the rain that is starting to go up. Well, it's been raining for most of the race. It hasn't stopped since about lap 12. I wonder how I'm going to look after I get to filming this episode number 72. I'm doing a great job on it so far. Seeing the cars, you know, avoiding mistakes. We're keeping it real here at the Circuit de Barcelona. after 40 and 66 laps here in the Spanish Grand Prix. 32-second advantage over my teammate, Calderon. He's still holding on within about 2 seconds ahead of him. Stay out there within the next 10 minutes because they said this lane is going to be clear enough. Goes into the pits. again. We're going to play the strategy and we're going to go. We already made one pit stop, and so we're going to make another pit stop and stay out there. My tires are still good. And this rain is starting to taper off a little bit. And the rain is beginning to taper off, and it's getting lighter and lighter out there once we progress. These tires are good until lap 55, so we should be able to change over, possibly maybe go back to the soft tires. We love playing this, we love to play this, this strategy game, and we're going to do it again for the third time. Yeah, I told you before, I wanted to play the strategy, right? And now we're going to be going back to a dry track. And this rain shortly is going to taper off. And then we have to wait, and they have to do the waiting game to see if we're going to go, when we're going to be going back to splits. Yeah, but look how wet the track is. It's going to take a while until it dries. Thank you. So after 48 and 66 laps, when we're still almost to the end of this race, and I'm about to complete my challenge, wearing these shades and then wearing this ninja mask on this Halloween night to win six in a row here at the Spanish Round, six in a row, and winning my first Spanish Round 3. I finished in sixth, third, and second. In the Spanish Grand Prix, I have not won it yet. And it looks like with this rain strategy, I'm about to do that. As it now tapered, as the rain has finally has tapered off. Very glad we stayed on the intermediate and not just go with the wet tires. They're slipping a little bit. Great Halloween day. I wish I told him I could dress as Harley Quinn, but you know, she's kind of squealing. Maybe she can be the Lady Happa. Goes into the pits. that's yours into the socks. It looks like Holder on to the... Oh, and Colderon goes in with the medium. So my teammate Colderon goes with the medium tire. Well, that was the right move to let her go with medium. We're going to be very fast on these tires because we are 26. Hold on, they lose second position to Valtteri Bottas because Bottas went with the soft tire. And I went with medium. And look at that, 19.009 on the medium. Oh, Lando Norris got the fastest time of the lead, 17. Now Colderon has to practice the class. Now I reached in with a 17.5753. One last remaining here in the Spanish Grand Prix, and I'm on my way of getting my sixth win in a row. I have been having a spectacular fourth season in my team JPO career mode. I wonder if I ever thought I would ever do this again, and it's coming right back at me. winning 6 Formula One races in a row. Faster than that lap with a minute and 17.559, but both times still quick. And the sun is back out here at Pacific California in the final 10 laps here at the Spanish Grand Prix. Hold on. is running faster than me. It looks like he has the better medium tires than I do. And if it wasn't for the rain and everything, it could have been a lot interesting. Going around a bit about it. But these rainy conditions have given us a big help with our strategy. And Coldwell is doing a great job with this medium tire strategy, and he is still doing excellent out there with those medium tires over Valtteri Bottas. Looks like both of his tires are starting to wear out. And Calderon, look at that. A minute 17.005. She indeed is pushing hard. Look at that. But I have a sizable lead because I've been doing a great job on the strategy. Once again, I do a tremendous job. Just like I did in Australia in the Dutch Grand Prix. Strategy, spending less time in the pit. And it's been working out very well in season 4 of my team, JPO F1. Well, we saw everybody else wearing their costumes, but they were open-face costumes. Love 46 was wearing the vampire costume. And then we saw another female that does these Formula One races. She was in the nun costume, and I am in the ninja costume. And Valtteri Bottas is in the pits. Oh man, what a tough break. Tough break for Valtteri Bottas, and now he's gonna lose a tremendous amount of time out of the pits, and he had to go and pit anyway to put another set of soft tires. But what a good job for Calderon. She doesn't have to pit at all, she's gonna stay out there. I'm glad she won with the medium tires. That was the right move for Tatiana Calderon. And we're on our way of getting our fourth 1-2 finish of the season. It'll be the 26th 1-2 finish of our career. Sometimes I made the right move going into the medium tires because I wasn't sitting right away and I would have lost that traction position. That was nice thinking over there, Calderon. Nice thinking to stay it with the medium tires, and I did the same thing too. And that was the right call. Two more laps remaining here in the Spanish Grand Prix, and I'm going to go with my sixth win in a row. This will be the last race I'll be using the first component of the gearbox as well. 40 seconds ahead of Tatiana Calderon, and we did it again on the strategy with the clear conditions, and then the rain conditions really helped, and I stayed on the same tires until lap 46, and then brought it home until lap 51, and then brought it home and finished it up with the medium tires. Here it is, the final lap here in the Spanish Grand Prix. What a terrific performance on Halloween night here in the Spanish Grand Prix. And I'm on my way of getting six in a row. We've done it again on the strategy. And me and Calderon are on our way of getting our fourth 1-2 finish of the season. Final time around at the circuit in Barcelona. And then going around the S's and then right into the hole. And we did it again on strategy once again. As we're on our way and we take the checkers. Six in a row in my team table. Six in a row. And we did it and we beat the challenge. Excellent, excellent job. And another 1-2 finish for me and Calderon. Fourth one of the season, 26-1-2 of our career. But it's also the fourth one with Calderon because I already did 22 of them with Perez. Well, I can take this talk now because I've already beat the challenge. What an amazing job. Another strong race for Tatiana Calderon. I remember she started in P2 and I started P3, and posted about three Valtes still was too slow. And spent too much time coming into the pits and everything, and then it lost the strategy off. Yeah, now I'm going to take this off and everything. Man, that was such once again. If it was a clear day, you know, Calderon would have made history here at the Spanish Grand Prix, but the rain helped us out once again, and it paid off once again. And we went a spooky Halloween night here in the Spanish Grand Prix, six in a row. And look how much time everybody else spent their time on their pit stops. They spent four pit stops, and we were the only drivers to spend only organization, and then Mercedes finishes third and fourth, but Valtes and Hamilton and Ocon round up the top five. What a great day for Ocon. He was the driver of the day, starting from 13th all the way to fifth. Lando Norris did a good job from 12th to 8th. They were running fourth to fifth during rainy conditions, but then and what a faltering performance for Sebastian Vettel. Fourth performance are by him. And it's starting to falter a little bit. And Tatiana Calderon, she's spot in the standings, but Valtteri Bottas is now in P2, moves up to second over Lewis Hamilton, his teammate, and Calderon still stays in four. Verstappen fifth, Albon sixth, Leclerc seventh. Sainz 8th beat Gasly 9th, and Ocon with that 5th place finish rounds out the top 10, and with 69 ahead of Valtteri Bottas. By single margins for 2nd, 3rd, and 4th, so Calderon could have a chance in that crown jewel race in the Monaco Grand Prix, and maybe if she might be able to get P2 if she does a great performance there. Maybe she'd become the first woman ever to get a pole position at the Monaco Grand Prix, so we'll see. I can't wait for that race. The Monaco Grand Prix, and look at that, 233 points in the constructor standings over Mercedes. Red Bull Racing is third, Renault fourth, and McLaren rounds out the top five. We're certainly going to take a look at the highlights of this race. Let's see it on. Even though Bottas took the pole, I started in P3, and Calderon was started in P2. And look at that, I was right in the middle. What a great start. And good concentration by Calderon for not making contact with Wayne some damage, and then I took the early lead. Not a bad Halloween challenge over there. Well, at least the werewolf giving me good luck too. Well, this isn't really a werewolf, it's the beast. Well, my car ran a beast today, and they see the rainy conditions. They're going to show maybe a small highlight of coverage on that. Man, I had no idea I had some front damage on the car too. I think it was because I ran over the bumps over in the hairpin. I ran it many times, and there's the finish of the race, but it still held on, and then it ended up finishing the race in dramatic fashion. And a great job for me and Colton. We did it again, and six in a row, but let's see if I can make a lucky seven in the next one in the crown jewel race for the Monaco Grand Prix. And we are going to change our car and change everything, because we're going to change into our major holiday colors for the next race. We're going to change from green to red, starting tomorrow to begin the major holiday season. And let's advance and let's talk with Claire about this great Spanish Grand Prix on Halloween night. Looks like my head is going numb but I breathe in a little bit more. It feels much better, and I won my sixth race in a row, and the strategy worked very well, and that gave us a big plus of bonus and everything, spending less time in the pits, and we've done it again, and it's fun to job, and then finally I win the Spanish Grand Prix. It took me four seasons to do it, and it wasn't easy. Strategy great, and then we stayed out there and until the rains come through, and then put intermediate tires. We only made one stop just putting on the intermediate tires once. We didn't have to put it twice, and then after the dry conditions came, then we put the medium tires on, finished it the rest of the way, and we won it. And that's how we pulled it off. Well, Colaron did an excellent performance in the beginning of the race. I was a little worried that she was going to do well with the medium tires, but she made the right move with the medium tires, and I'm very proud of her. And she put the right tires on, and not like she did lost the T7, but this time she did it right this time, and then put the right tires on, and then ended up with the second place finish. And great job for my teammate, and let's see if she can make big history with the crown jewel race in the next one at the Monaco Grand Prix. We are going to be changing our uniforms back to our green and red color so we can get ready for the major holiday. Well, the JPG will be a temporary sponsor, but we'll go back to that a different sponsor for the next one. Once that expires, until maybe the next four or five races, and then we'll be back to our original sponsor. But we go up to 9 million so far. But what a great job for me and Colin. We did an excellent job at the Spanish Grand Prix. She got a run on me, but still, like, she's a little too late. But Colin's going to win the race one day. Any of these races, she will be winning a race. Don't worry. She is going to make history. But only time will tell. We'll see which one of these episodes it's going to be. And I'll let you know that it is going to be fascinating if she gets that first win. She's already got 5 podiums this season. And she's on the wall. I think she has 4 podiums this season. But she is in a spectacular role so far. But I did it. I beat my challenge. Wearing this and then wearing my shades. I tell you what, it was a great Halloween challenge. Excellent job. And I still saw everything and all that. I was totally ready. Well, it's really 7:48 right now because, remember, the daylight savings time is it's at 8:48, but then after that, it's going to be 7:48. Well, I think everybody has left tonight because everybody's doing their trick-or-treating right now. And look at this, and now we are going to have new sponsors on the car. Yeah, our sponsorship has to be renewed. But even though we get the JPG sponsors, but we are going to have new sponsors coming up on the car. Visit sponsorship headquarters, so we'll put that as 1250. Because we like visitors going into our factory and everything, and you know, we've already completed mostly everything. Looks like all our spec upgrades are all full. We're still waiting on the powertrain and the resource power generation to fill up. Episode, we'll change to a new car and then for the Monaco Grand Prix, but it's going to be green and red for the major holiday season for the next 2 months. And then we'll also change our, we'll have the same suits, but we'll change our color as well with that. That'll be on the next episode, number 73, our Crown Jewel Edition. That'll be on Monday. It will be the Monaco Grand Prix. And let's see if Colin, then she's going to make some big history at the Monaco Grand Prix, and she's experienced here at this track. I remember for high school, she's doing great at the Monaco circuit, so we'll see. So that will do it for our Halloween edition of the Formula 1 My Team JPO F1 Remote, and thank you so much for watching a very spooky, unfamiliar kind of thing, and I beat the challenge wearing my shade mask, my covered ninja mask, and then my shades, and it pulled out very well, and I come away with my 6th win in a row, and I don't think I've ever done that, and nobody else has ever done that too on Twitch.tv or YouTube. But thanks everyone, and enjoy the rest of your Halloween night, and once again, happy Halloween, and then starting tomorrow, we start the major holiday season, and we will wish everyone happy holidays as well. And thanks so much. By November 10th, and then when that day comes, then we'll have a brand new console and new speakers coming up, and we'll have all those systems to get our new studio to be far more upgraded. So anyway, have a good Halloween night, and kids, stay safe out there, and hope you don't eat too much candy tonight, because it's going to be a long one, and we have daylight savings time. So thank you very much, and we'll see you. Enjoy the rest of your night. And we'll see you into the next one. Just starting out the major holiday. So long, everyone.